This time we'll take care of the routes like as we said last time. So for this one, we'll have a dedicated folder and file for routes. So here we'll create a directory and we'll call it routes. And then over here, we'll create a new file and we'll call it routes.dart, okay? And inside here, we'll create a new class and we'll call it routes class. Okay, so here we'll define all the routes, okay? So in general, you should define your routes with a string, a function, and a list. So these three things we need. So first we'll go ahead and define a static variable string for home route, and we'll call it home route would be always with a slash. And for this one here we'll have static string get home route. So as I said that we also need a function, so this function would return a string, okay? So the string we have defined early, that one, okay? All right. So because a lot of time if we use getx that needs a string as a route. Without string it works as well, but I think with string it's much better, you have better control. And then you also have to use create a list of your routes, and the type is get page. Okay, now for this one we need to import a library first, I mean getx get. Now here we'll call it routes, the list name. Okay, now it should also be static type because we want to access this properties using this routes class name. We'd use routes class dot like that. Okay, so here we'll define our get page function, I think that's okay. So get page for home route. Okay, all right, now it takes few parameters, like one is page and another one is name. Okay, so there's two. So in this case here the name is the one the class you want to call. So here we'd call it home screen because home screen is our main screen, which is this one. Okay, you need to import it as well. So we can just return one line over here. And over here the name is home, okay? All right, so this home name is this string's name, okay? So when you call this one using this one, so the string would refer to this string and then eventually it would return this one, okay? We'll see it very soon how it works. So now we'll go to main over here. Now we are going to define initial route. And in that case, we don't need home route. So here we do routes class dot get home route. Okay. Now it does take a string. Okay, as you see over here, and this one returns a string. If you go and see this one, the string is this one. So next time you need to change this one, you just change here, and everything else stays the same. This way, it's more organized and maintainable. Okay. So when you call this one, this refers to this string, which is this one. So these two are same. And then it finds from here, okay? So then it would refer to this home screen, okay? All right. And then we need to, because we'll have many routes. So here we have another property, which is called get pages. It takes a list of routes, but we already defined a list of routes here. So we'll just simply call this one, okay? So because this is already a list, so here we do routes class dot routes. Okay, so yeah, that's how you define routes in getx using a different separate file. Okay, so whatever the routes you have, you can always define them in a separate file and start to access them from your main page, okay, or main.dart file. Okay. All right. Okay, next, if you have more routes, just go ahead and do like this and you should be good to go. So next, well, now let's go ahead and restart our app. We see that, well, nothing really changed. Next, we want to, this view task over here, we want to put it over here, okay? Well, so for this one, first we'll declare a static variable, string view task, and here view task. Okay, and same as this one here, we also define this one, get view task route. Okay, and it would get view task for us. And over here, we'll just copy this one and we'll put it here. Now here we'll refer to view task. Okay, now here, of course, I think this is all task actually, not view task. So let's change all of them. All right. Okay, and over here, we'll call all tasks. Okay, now if you see and come over here from home page, which is this one, from here we are calling view task. Let's see, all task actually. So when you click on this button, we go to all task, but at the same time we see that we have defined this animation, so we can copy this animation and we can come to a routes class and we'll just simply put it here. Okay, animation. Okay, all right, now here it might need const, so let's add the const modifier. Okay, now from our home screen over here, this time we can just simply comment this out. We don't need this now, just comment it out first, and here we would do okay. Yes, it works, and we can still go back. It's a beautiful animation, right? You see, yeah, that's where Getx shines again, and this is the reason I love Getx so much, because it does come with some cool animations. So we don't need this one anymore, so we are done with this. And okay, now just now I was saying that if you use two named, you need a string. Now in our case routes, this one, it returns a string. But if you use off, let's see, where was it? Yeah, just a two, that takes a dynamic page, as you see, two. Get the two. Okay, if you hover over on it, you will see that, here, dynamic page, okay? So that's different, that directly takes a class name instead of like this, because this one returns a string. And when it does, it comes over here, and for that string, it finds the class. So it's a little detour, but it has its own benefit, and we'll see why. Okay, all right, hopefully it makes sense. Now, we don't need this one, so we do the same for our add task, okay? Now, here, we'll just simply, well, first thing, let's see, we have to define it first. So here, I'll copy this one. And here I would say add task. Add a task. I think I can copy this one. So here get add a task route. Okay, and here it's add a task. And here we'll just copy this one. And here, add a task. Now, this is the file that we need to import. Let's do it. And here we'll put add a task. Now, this animation we'll copy from here, whatever we were given. So, let's see. So, I'll copy this section first and just replace this one. Okay, cool. But here it takes a different property, which is a transition duration. Okay, now let's restart. Let's restart. Okay, so here view all, we don't have anything. Now here add task, this one. Now you can go back. It's beautiful. Okay, all right. So yes.